Welcome back. I'm actually thrilled to be out here in Cannes. It's early September. It's relatively early in the morning. And I'm saying that also to make my apologies for keeping my sunglasses on. The sun actually is quite low, so I really can't do without my sunglasses. But yet, it is great to be here in this blue water. It's 3 meters deep here. It's really, this is what we long for coming from the Netherlands. And sitting here on this Sea Ray SDX250 in lounge mode with the early September morning sun, this is the life, I would say. But we've taken out this Sea Ray SDX250, of course, to show you how nice a boat it is. And what I personally like about the SDX series is that they have an extremely roomy bow. They don't have the sharp point bow, but a bigger bow which creates lots of volume. And this is a 25 footer, which is not a really small bow rider, but still, being a 25 footer, the area here, the space you have is huge, considering again that it's a 25 footer. I'm sitting here now on a really comfortable seat with high backrest like we're used to with Sea Ray, and all the nice details I'll go through. But there's also a possibility to have a filler piece right here, where now you have this beautiful optional teak table in the bow. But you could fill this and have this converted to a full sun lounge, which is actually quite nice. And usually in practice, this is the space where the kids tend to stay. But now I'd love to stay here during this full day, but you have to head back to the Cannes Boat Show. But still a great bow area, very roomy. As a standard, there's a cooler below here. It's been taken out for use at the stand, but that is supposed to go here, protected with this nice netting. An anchorage right here, really nice, of course, with the stainless steel anchor, which is now on the sea bottom. You won't be able to see this, but there's a small window here for the small cabin, which is underneath, which will come to later. Just want to point out this window, which creates some ventilation in that cabin area. There's cup holders. I see two here and two there. There's non-skid on the bow, and again here with the bow being extremely wide all the way up to the front, there's plenty of possibility to get on and off the boat if you're moored in a way that this is practical, and then you have the non-skid so you don't fall off easily. And again, Sea Ray is known for all its details, really lengthy seating bases. What I see often is that some builders have an area such as this, but then the seat bases are like this. And if you do sit here for a couple of hours, it's really not comfortable. So lengthy seat bases, but not only that, this is slightly elevated, which is a nice detail to look at, but not only that, it has a practical thing because you don't slide off being in rougher waters. And you see the double stitching on many places, all the attention to details, these nice panels with the honeycomb structure here. You see a Fusion speaker here. There's a premium stereo from Fusion on this boat. What I like, by the way, with Fusion is, of course, the quality of the sound is extremely nice because they have what they call a DSP. I think the word is digital sound processor. So you can really tune a boat, which is done by Sea Ray / Fusion, which creates a great sound. But not only that, there's a party mode. So if we were to have like four boats here and they all have this Fusion system, they could all run the same music at the same time, which I think is a really great feature. There's grab rails, stainless steel 316 quality, of course. And also here, being in the bow, the backrest is lower for visibility also from behind the wheel, but still this is a great place to sit if you want to be the other way around. There's a windshield wiper there, which seems logical, but there still be boats, sea boats in this caliber, which don't have a windshield wiper. Very useful, especially on salt water, where you tend to, in rougher conditions, get some water over the windshield. You may see this filler cap, which is for the water tank. You can have an outside shower, which is on the back. There's a 12 volt plug here. And you may notice that there's sea deck on the floor here, which being a Dutch dealer, we notice is very much appreciated by our customers. Not only does it look good, but it's very practical. When we arrived at the stand this morning, but was completely wet because they had just cleaned it, but you don't need to really dry it. It's easy. If you walk on it with bare feet, it's really comfortable and it looks good. Here it's in the brown color. You can have it in a gray color also. And with the upholstery, this is a brownish color. You have different options, brown, white, gray, ivory, stone and dune. This is the dune setting. A nice Sea Ray logo engraved like we're used to with Sea Ray, tinted windows. So again, lots of attention to detail, nice hinges in stainless steel. And also these are made from stainless steel. So yeah, a premium quality Sea Ray SDX250. Let me take you back. And what I like also about this boat is that this is a different layout. These boats used to have a walkthrough right in the center, coming to the bow area, which of course works fine and is still used with other boats from Sea Ray. But what I like is that they have now this walkthrough possibility on the port side, which means that you have different possibilities to create a bow such as this. So you have a really beamy bench here. It looks good, it's comfortable, it's cozy, but not only that, this is quite easy to get to. And if you have small kids, you can see that the freeboard, this is actually really high, which makes you feel sheltered, safe, and you don't really, you're not afraid to fall overboard. So I really like this, and that is an advantage. But another advantage is that there's a small cabin right here. Of course, you can close this like this, so you take away the wind in early spring when the wind is quite chilly. There's a small door here to close it even further. And going back, let me take you into the cabin. I'll quickly go inside. It's not a cabin which is intended to sleep in. Even though it's a really nice area and it could be used for small kids to take a nap or to sit here by the end of the day when they're getting tired and they just want to stay out of the sun and take their swimming vest off. So I couldn't lie here, but a kid of maybe up to 12 years old, I don't know, could lie here, take a nap. And this is, of course, also a great place to store stuff. Really easy, you come on board, you always have bags and lots of stuff. You just put it in, the boat still remains tidy. It's easy to get it in and out. You won't see this, but there is a possibility to also get some heat in here. Early spring, not only could you have colder weather, of course, but if there would be dampy conditions, you could take the moisture out of the cabin. So a really good solution, and that is done by using the heat from the engine. And below me actually is the toilet. Let me do it like that. And I think actually they found a really good solution for this. So I'm putting it up like this. And let me go to this side again. So you can see that there's a really decent toilet here. Being the 1.93 meter guy, let me show you how lengthy this is. Even being 1.93 meter, there's plenty of space. So a really practical, good, usable toilet. There's a light here, nice fiberglass, nice details. There's leather here. There's a net here to carry some stuff. I really like this. Toilet is electric as a standard, by the way. So flush with the fresh water so it doesn't start to smell. Let's put this down so that we can drive fast later. Let me close this door. Of course, a really nice cockpit with the possibility to turn this. Let me quickly. What I should say is that this is a pre-production model. So some details may still change. This, as you notice, takes a bit of effort. I know that the same applies to the bench here, the backrest here. So that still needs some fine tuning at Sea Ray, but I'm sure that is solved in the final production boats. But this can be converted on that side, on the port side, starboard side, creating a huge cockpit space. Let me fold this open, and you can have really a nice area to do some socializing with family and friends. But I really like this. Being a 25 footer, having this huge a space is, I think, really a nice solution. So Sea Ray did a really good job. And while I'm sitting here, you again see all these details with the nice upholstery, with lots of detailing, with this different color here and honeycomb structure, lots of stitching. It's really good. There's cup holders there, and lots of different places where you have cup holders. Of course, they did not forget about storage. There's a relatively big storage below here, where you could even put like a wakeboard. There's storage below here. There's usually a cooler as a standard below here. And there, as an option, you could have an electric fridge below that seat there. That is in this boat, and it's actually quite big. It's even practical on a boat show to carry some drinks for all the stand guys to drink a small beer after the show. And I'm noticing this fire port, which I think in the US is mandatory by law. That is actually not really necessary in a Sea Ray, because every Sea Ray has an automatic fire extinguishing system in the engine bay. So makes you just feel safe. I really love this practical table, by the way, also with this L-shaped foot here, so that it's not in the way and it's not being a hazard here. Small storage here, main switches here, a door you can close there to add a bit of extra safety. What else do I need to show you? I'll come back to the helm station later when we take the boat out. But going back, again, storage here. This can be closed. This is where you have the outside shower. So having taken a plunge in this really fantastic blue French waters and wanting to rinse the salt off, this is really practical. Again, the sea deck is a material which can handle it all, no problem whatsoever. It's been used by Sea Ray and other brands for quite a few years now. We, being a Dutch dealer, of customers who've had it, I don't know, 5 years or plus, they're all really happy with it. So I think a really good option, but of course you could have carpet. There's infinity flooring is an option in, I think, not all Sea Rays, but something I like also. But this is just very practical when you do a lot of swimming or wakeboarding, water skiing, and it tends to get wet. It's again easy to clean, comfortable, so a personal recommendation. This could again fold the other way, so you have a really good area here. Let me just take the effort again. This is a pre-production boat, so I know this is a bit of a struggle. It's quite okay today. So again, I'm 1.93 meters. I'm way above average lengthwise, but you can see even with my length, there's plenty of space. I mean, if I slide in right in the corner, I think you could even have three people here if they're not all too big. So a really great place. And being here now, anchoring, looking at these blue waters, I can imagine myself really enjoying a nice day and the time here. There's a cup holder here, so imagine yourself sitting here with a nice French glass of rosé, music coming from the speakers. There's one here, there's 12 volt connections here for your iPhone or iPad or whatever. So really practical, and that is something that we're used to from Sea Ray. They're one of the biggest and one of the oldest sport boat builders worldwide. And you see that there's attention to detail and lots of practical things. There's just so much experience that I think this is really a perfect boat. There's some nice features. You can have a submersible swim platform here. And let me show you, now that we're here in waters which are, I think, 25 degrees or so, this is one way of using this submersible swim platform. Again, imagine yourself sitting here. It's actually quite comfortable using this as a backrest with your feet in the water, having a cold drink. Or if you have people doing wakeboarding, people who are used to that know that it can be actually quite a struggle sitting on the bathing platform to take a wakeboard, to put it on or to take it off. I know from experience that it's a lot easier when you have something like this to have it lower and get the wakeboard on and off more easily. There's a tow hook here for wakeboarding and other things to tow. Of course, the full area here opens up to have access to the engine bay. There's a grab rail here. There is a standard bathing ladder on one of these sides. I don't know by heart which side, but there is one as a standard. So you always have a good way of getting in and out of the water. So yeah, again, a great bathing platform. It's actually relatively big also. I like the size of it being quite lengthy. Storage there. The nice Sea Ray cleats with the Sea Ray logo engraved. The filler cap there for the gasoline. Really nice. Bimini. We folded it in. We could actually use it today. With the sun being out, I think we'll have up to close to 30 degrees. But we folded it in to have just this better view. So again, a really nice cockpit. Let us just quickly take the anchor out and take the boat out for a spin, and then I'll tell you all about the helm. We'll be right back. A really fantastic helm here. Of course, there's lots to see. There's switches, like we're used to with Sea Ray. They're made from stainless steel with a small light in, a nice detail, which I appreciate driving boats at night. There's Fusion stereo here, an upgraded control system here. This Simrad screen you can have in a 9-inch version or a 12-inch version. This actually is the 12-inch version, which I really like. There's different ways to set this up. And here, and that is something which I personally really am happy with, that Sea Ray has taken the option of having bow thrusters down from bigger boats to smaller boats. So now you can have on this SDX 250 a bow thruster, which I think is a really good thing and makes boating a lot easier. Even having lots of experience like I have, I've been doing boating for professionally for more than 30 years now. I always say when you take a boat in a mooring, going backwards with the force five from the side, being all by yourself, that is not a good thing to do if you don't have a bow thruster. And if you do, you just go in and out without any issues. So a really good thing to have on this Sea Ray SDX 250. Of course, there's the digital throttle and shift, DTS. The boat comes with a MacCruiser 8-cylinder, 6.2 liter, 300 horsepower with a duo prop, which means that it's more steady, really good acceleration. It's smooth and quiet. Boats with the stern drive tend, when you drive slowly, tend to go like this a bit. If you have a duo propeller, a double propeller that is, it makes the boat go straight in a better way. There's a nice visor, leather wrapped here, to take away a bit of the sunshine. But even being, especially now with the sun still quite low, again, it's early in the morning, and really aiming between brackets at this Simrad screen, I can still really clearly see this screen. Some people tend to use iPhones or iPads for navigation, but I really am convinced if I would have that now, not a chance to see it in the way that you have it now on this Simrad 12-inch screen. I'm sitting here in the elevated position with this flip-up possibility, and as you may notice, the ergonomics here are really good. I have a really good angled footrest here, which makes me pushing myself back into the backrest, into the seat here. So this is a position I tend to use in waters where there's waves which are a bit rough, so that you're protected, you feel stable and safe steering this boat. But if you'd be in my hometown, Aalsmeer, where we have really flat waters and it's nice and quiet, relaxed, you fold this down, you sit here, and even then I sit here really comfortably, and you can even tilt or lower this steering wheel. If you were to sit like this, you would lower it. I'm taking it up again because that for me is just a bit nicer, also because I'm not so known in this area in the south of France, so I really need to keep my eye open on where to go and on the other boats. But again, digital throttle and shift also. It's nice and smooth because there's no cables anymore. So even after 10 years, it's still exactly the same as it is on day one upon delivery. But not only that, it makes the boat more quiet, because with the cables, which are still used in different other boats, that tend to take noise from the engine through the controls here. But that doesn't happen in this solution, where it's a drive-by-wire system, so you eliminate a lot of the sound. You can start and stop the engine. You could use the trim here, but this boat is also equipped with the Mercury Active Trim, which you can control from this screen. Most our customers try to win from the Active Trim by doing it themselves, but you actually, from my experience, you can't. It's a really good system, and what most of my customers do is they put it in their preferred user profile. You have a setting going from 1 to 5, with 5 being the most aggressive way to trim and 1 being the most conservative. Most people just choose somewhere in the middle, leave it there all the time, and it just works fine. I think now it's on number 2, which is really good, and you really don't have to care about trimming the engine. There's quite some waves here from a ferry passing by. Let me go through them bow first. Another problem, no spray, nothing. But again, a really nice setup with the helm here. I'm forgetting about the trim tabs. The controls are here. Sitting here really comfortably. This is the 6.2 V8, a really powerful engine with a lot of torque. So if I want to take the boat up to plane, which I will be doing now, people will notice that it really is powerful, and this feels like it's really no effort to get up to plane. We're now only 2 people with, I don't know, 80, 90 liters of fuel, so it's relatively light, but I really am convinced that if you were to carry 6, maybe even 8 passengers now, it would still take the boat up to plane without any problem. I'm gently pushing the controls now, just to be a bit gentle to the camera guy who's with us, Thijs. So I am up to plane. We have the setting on knots, doing 15 knots now. With a nice morning breeze being out here in Cannes. I think it's already close to 25 degrees, perfect conditions. It is a bit bumpy here. That is quite a difference from where we usually do our reviews. But that is actually quite a nice and different experience for a change. Doing 18, 19 knots in the meantime. A really nice speed to take on trips, to some tours. 21 knots in the meantime. This is still a speed in which you can talk, start to notice the engine, but it still is really nice and comfortable, even on relatively bumpy seas, which we have today. I'm not sure whether it's a good idea to try and get her up to maximum speed, but let's try it anyway. Only shortly, I have to keep my eye open for all the boats around. There are many moored here on anchor. 24, 25. Approximately. I won't go any further because it's not really comfortable with these bumpy seas here at the moment. I have a feeling that the active trim needs a bit of adjusting, but it really runs nice and smoothly. So I really like driving this boat. Let me also take some short turns. There's some huge boats around us. Fun to be in this area again, between all kinds of different boats. Let me see if we're getting spray from our own waves. Nothing. It's really dry. Taking even shorter turns. Let me try the other direction. Turning the wheel with just one hand with this power assisted steering. Even shorter turns. No problem whatsoever. I really like this nice salty water. This is really nice for a change. Well, I hope you liked it as much as I did. This again is a pre-production model. There's a Sea Ray SDX 250 outboard out here also, but we won't manage to test that unfortunately. But I hope to be doing one sometime next year, 2022. There will be a few of these boats at our facility soon, I hope. But again, thank you for watching. Keep in mind that it's a pre-production. And let me know if you have any questions by leaving a remark below this video. For now, thank you for watching. Please keep following us, and I hope to see you in our next videos.